brought to you by Waffle House.
Hey, this is Carl from Nile, and you're listening to Metal-O-Mania.
This is Dawn of the Dead from Nunslaughter, and you're watching Metal-O-Mania. Hey, man. Is that Metal-O-Mania?
Yeah, man.
Well, turn it up.
It's judgment time, baby.
Yum, yum. Salty meat in my mouth all day, please.
trying to start a riot up in here?
I'd rather have a bottle in front of me than a frontal lobotomy. Boom!
No more pain. It's lobotomy. Isn't that for loonies?
And now for something completely different.
And welcome back to Metal-O-Mania Studios, where I'm joined by my new friends out of fucking Kansas City, Missouri. What's up, gentlemen? How are you today?
What's up, man?
Doing good.
Doing good.
Well, you've been the soundtrack to my life for the last couple of weeks, guys. I just want you to know that, man. So, for starters.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you for joining me. I appreciate your time very, very much. Well, for those who are late to the party, and you are out there, if you don't have this album already, you are. But if they're late to the party, let them know who you are, guys, and introduce yourselves to them.
We're Kohnerah. My name is JD.
I'm Spencer, bass guitar.
I play guitar.
Book, yeah. And who are the rest of the guys that aren't with you that make up the band?
Stephen Babcock is the vocalist. He was going to be here tonight but couldn't. Our comedic relief as well as vocalist.
Yeah, way so funnier than us.
Well, he didn't come because he saw how ugly I was, man. Tell him I get it. I understand. I'm not the first, won't be the last, but
then we got Chris Thorpe on drums and Joshua Riley on second guitar.
Fuck yeah. And you have a debut album that is now out in the world, man. How does that feel to fucking get that fucker out there?
Fucking great, man.
Like, about time. Like, a lot of time and a lot of effort into it.
Yeah.
But it's finally, it came out right when it needed to.
I had to get that out.
Yeah. Right when I needed it to, I'll tell you that. And after some tumultuous years, man, I got to imagine some of those. I got to imagine you jumped a few hurdles. I'll just put it that way to get it out there.
As a matter of fact, it wasn't easy.
Oh, yeah.
The vid was a big one, too. I mean, there was already some before. But, yeah, that really kind of fucking derailed us a little bit, but we got back on track.
Yeah.
And
fuck,
we are 2023 with the...
We're on course now.
And I do. I love it. I've been devouring it as I should, as a metalhead should, from start to finish in the order of release.
The way it was meant to be.
But, let's start from the script. I noticed you have some pretty kick-ass artwork. How'd you land that from... I'm going to fuck his name up, but
Marius Lewandowski.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. Yeah, so we anticipated the album coming out a lot sooner than it did, and we actually messaged him and talked to him back in, God, it must have been 20, like early 2021 or sometime around there. Like, we had the artwork for a while. We were like sitting on it.
Badass. You know, I'll show it to people here while we're talking about it here, man. There it is right there.
So, yeah, we talked to him, and I mean, he was such a cool dude to talk to, honestly. I mean, just like one of the most down to earth people I've ever talked to, and it was, you know, just he was just, I don't know, so helpful as far as like giving us options as far as what we wanted to do and everything. And
right, I've often wondered how that process plays out. Do you go to the artist and say kind of this is my vision, and then, you know, bounce it back and forth, or are you just kind of like, hey man, do whatever the fuck you're feeling, or
show me what you got?
In this case, actually, I initially hit him up to try to see if, you know, what our options would be for like an original piece. And then we ended up talking about some other pieces that he had available. And like, it's crazy because Josh and I actually sat down and sort of drew like a sketch of like what we kind of wanted. And before we even, this was before we talked to Marius Lewandowski. And then when I messaged him and talked to him and he showed us this piece, I was like, dude, this is perfect. This is like, so it was one he actually already had done.
But like he stole it out of your head. Yeah. See,
dude, it was just too good to be true. Like, what the hell? What the fuck? Like, this is crazy.
That's fucking perfect.
So we just went with it.
It represents the name very well. It's pretty.
That story is serendipitous, which I guess is the opposite of the name, right? Ominous Ubiquitous is the name out there, ladies and gentlemen, which for those who skipped the last couple of years of school, that is what all signs point to closing in darkness, right? I mean,
right, like bad things happening all around us, something like that, you know?
Yeah. It's the end of society as we know it.
It's kind of an all-encompassing explanation of what the themes of all the songs are. Like, all the songs have bad things happening in them. Like, so.
Fuck yeah. Well, as does the world, I would say. So, yeah.
Art imitates life.
I don't know too many metalheads that are buying a bunch of records looking for love songs, baby. We want the calamitous shit, you know, so.
Right.
And on that point, home run on this album, guys. Home run on that.
Thank you.
Take me into the studio with you a little bit. When do you guys together? Tell me a little bit about the process. Is it a riff starts the thing and then the ball gets rolling? Is it a lyrical fucking concept that you have in mind? Is it a combination of those things? Kind of what brings your music to the surface?
Tell us about your process.
Yeah, I mean, thinking back to how it all first started, it was always just like, I mean, initially it seemed like it was always a riff, you know, just one of us had a riff idea, and then our original drummer, Ryan Bender, would just start throwing out ideas for drum beats and getting the sort of the feel and the groove down there. And, you know, we would jam around on riffs like that for a while, trying to figure out, you know, what's going to work best and what variations there could be there.
Mix it up in a pot, making it spicy.
Oh my Lord.
I mean, I think it worked really well like that. And then we just started developing the songs from there. But I mean, there were other times where, you know, somebody had a lead idea or like sort of a harmony idea or a melody that they wanted to incorporate. And we would, you know, sort of tackle things that direction too. So
there was a couple songs that were back and forth riffs from JD. You would have a mm-hmm. riff, Josh would inject one and vice versa.
Right.
And same with like leads over them and stuff. And, you know, just kick it around at practice. And Bender would just, you know, kind of go from there. And then it'd just be born from there. Babcock would just scream his cock off. And
fuck yeah. Okay, so, I'm getting the image of an all hands on deck process, though. That I do. That always album, tends absolutely. To be.
Yep.
Yeah.
For the most part, yeah, absolutely. Most of the songs were a lot of collaborative efforts.
It was. We worked on shit outside of practice, but like it was like every week when we had practice, it was like we were there to get shit done, you know, try to figure shit out and sort of figure out what the hell our sound was or what we wanted to do or, you know, where we wanted to go with things. And honestly, like, it was open.
That. I mean, like, the progression in the album, it's like, yeah. You know, it's like Wake of Oblivion was the first song that this band had written before I was even doing a bass in the band. And then like Antimatter and so on and so forth. And obviously, take a guess what the last two songs were pretty much written.
Come on, make a guess.
The last two on the album.
Right, so. Yeah, right, exactly.
So it really, it showed such a, and maybe that's because it was so much time going into it, which I think is great. And I think a lot of people have noticed that there's a progression through it, which is really fucking cool in one fucking album.
Right.
I mean, a lot of,
fuck yeah.
Riffs, and we got the fucking, you know.
That's whatever. A sign of a band growing together, and instead of individuals, it's the band growing together, I always think. Well, you know, yeah. I'll tell you, you're officially on the clock even, man. You're a part of my experiment now. I have a theory that bands that work all-inclusive like that tend to be the bands that last longer. So back me up on this, man. Go keep going doing this thing forever, you know?
Hey, this is JD with Kohnerah. I just want to chime in and say we're really going to miss Josh. He's been a huge part of everything Kohnerah has done. We love him. We wish him the best. Kohnerah is still alive and well, and we will have announcements soon.
Yeah, there's already new stuff already being written. So, I mean, there's going to be at least another one.
There will be more.
Fuck yeah. Well, tell me, we'll get to that. Tell me a little bit about the release. Were you able to do a proper release for this album? Were you able to kind of go through that process, get it out there right?
He did a fucking amazing job. Him and his wife and a few other key people have done amazing releasing this album.
Awesome.
Other bands that, you know, that I've been in and stuff. And it's like, I don't know, JD, for just almost just kind of like, well, I think this is what you do. And I think it did really good. I mean, hey, we're here.
That's my favorite approach, brother. So, yeah, fuck yeah. That's what we do here. So,
it's just a painful, brutal process of trial and error.
We appreciate that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I kicked around the idea, and, you know, we probably talked about the idea of shopping it around to see if we could, you know, get somebody to release it. But ultimately, so much time had passed. I was just like, I just want to get this thing released.
Fuck yeah, man.
The
time is now.
Yeah, I'm not fucking around with labels or anything. I don't care. Come just hell or high water. We're just going to push it out there. And I mean, it's done, honestly, better than I expected it would, like, for an independent release. So I'm really happy about it.
Well, you know, I owe a hand job to whoever sent it to my email. I'll just say that. But you know, fuck, I better find out who that was. I'm gonna have a whole bunch of people trying to collect that fucking thing.
I got a line foreman in here that's longer than my grandma's tits.
But anyway. But that's awesome, man. Are you able, guys, able to really start getting out there live yet? Is that kind of, is that, hopefully, I'm hoping 2023 is the year of just assaulting people live. What's your plan there? Is it something you're bringing from the studio onto stages? What's kind of your rollout here?
Why don't you spit it out, you quack?
Well, I mean, we've done all these songs live. Actually, all of them except for one, we've done live quite a few times. And you know, mostly just like local shows that we've played here and there in between, like our writing process and recording.
My favorite shows, man, are fucking
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite kind.
But we did manage to go up and do Slam Dakota a couple years ago, and that was pretty cool. That was in the middle of the whole recording process. We just kind of wanted to get out and do something, and that was a fun little festival to do. But yeah, I mean, as far as like, I mean, honestly, we've been practicing every week, and I mean, we're for the most part show ready. But we're
the show.
Yeah, we're getting there. We're for the most part there, and hoping to get back out on the stage soon.
Just one more test, and then we are ready for the world.
I have knee surgery in about 12 minutes, but no. But I'm trying to get into mosh pits, man. As you know, I put together a pretty, in my opinion, a fucking killer dance video for an Oculus. But I need to get in front of a stage and do that shit live, man. I need to throw my ass around to that shit. So yeah, let me know, brother. This 2023, I got a feeling this album is got legs on it, man. I'm just gonna say, I got a feeling this motherfucker is gonna take you a couple of places onto some stages that you may not have anticipated. And I look forward to talking to you again after some of that shit happens, man. Because I'm enjoying the fuck out of this record, gentlemen, for real, very much.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Thank you.
We're glad that it's getting recepted like that. So.
Fucking. So, motherfucking rock solid, rock solid.
It doesn't got any better than this, Beavis.
Yep.
Well, what are you most looking forward to as 2023 spring hits? Are there any things that you're kind of like on your calendar, like, man, I can't wait for that motherfucker, or is it kind of a play day by day situation still, or what's up?
Yeah, I think we're trying to just get back into the swing of it, fucking, as far as playing together again process goes. We had quite a bit of downtime there after we recorded the shit. So, and then of course trying to promote it and push it out there, that also, you know, made it to where like we were, you know, a little short on time and couldn't really practice every week. So yeah, we're trying to get back to just, you know, playing and hope to play live and also writing some new shit. Like he said, I mean, mm-hmm. I think we got, I don't know, at least a decent start on about three or four songs already. So
there's a good chance it might just be back to the going back into the writing. And
yeah.
Stuff, but I mean, there'll still be a couple sporadic shows here and there. And, you know,
right. You know,
taking it day by day.
That's a sign of the times, honestly. There's a lot of bands we talk to these days that are like, man, we're going to make it. We're going to put it out there. You know, we'll do the shows when and where we can. But it's kind of, you know, more of a studio driven thing, you know. And to all those bands and to you, I say, man, I implore you. Yeah. Get out there live. I need you live. So
yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
There's nothing else like it in the whole world.
We'll see you guys.
Yeah. That's soon. Definitely a point that we, you know, we definitely want to play live. But yeah, I think, for some, you know, the logistics of playing live nowadays, which is
are not what they used to be for sure.
It's not the same.
We live in a different world than we did just 30 seconds ago.
Well, though, although I will say, with the music sales end of it, you know, in order for you to, you know, the live shows are where you're going to get money when you, you know, I mean, that's, you know, the album's going to make dick.
Ain't that the truth?
And, you know, the days of selling albums and making money off them are practically gone. So, you know, you need to hit them stages and sell the merch.
Yep.
Well, and as far as moving digits, I think is the way they call it these days. What is the best way to get their hands on a hard copy of the record? Do you guys got hard copies available? Is it still digital? Is it something I can, You know, if I want to get a copy signed by you cats, man, how do I fucking follow up on getting that shit?
Yeah, you can order it. Kohnerah.com is the best place. The hard copy of the album, and we have a couple of t-shirts on there as well.
If you use the site, we actually get more of that money.
Yeah,
you know, it's that helps.
Really, oh, helps. 1,000%. I think that's key, in fact, man. You know, cut out as many middlemen as possible.
Let's cut out the middleman where I shit my pants.
I'm a broken record on this show that we can't say enough. If you enjoy the art, you have to feed the artist, man. Buy the record, buy the t-shirt, buy the fucking hard copy, buy the fucking, you know.
Helps, and we appreciate it.
Sit on the shitter later and read them fucking lyrics if they're in there and see who the fucking, you know what I mean? Who did the band thank? What the fuck, you know? So,
right. Yeah, it's a great gatefold too. It's nice.
Oh, well, I'll have to get my hard copy myself then. Fuck yeah. Oh, see, there you go. I love it. nothing replaces. If you're a listener of pop music or maybe jazz or whatever the fuck, you can do all that Spotify you want to. If you're a metalhead, man, you need the hard copy, baby. That's,
yeah,
you know, honestly.
I mean, yeah, and I think we've kicked around the ideas of vinyls and stuff, but that whole situation seems like it's a long waiting list, so I wouldn't expect it anytime soon.
Yeah, vinyl's a tough market at the moment, so hopefully that returns. But yeah, we're hearing a lot of negativity about the vinyl market these days. The vinyl itself apparently is just really hard to get,
extremely expensive, and only used by a select few.
Yeah,
high demand, I guess.
Yeah, I guess so. Crazy stuff, man. Crazy stuff. Well, tell me a little bit about the song. I remind everybody, Kohnerah.com, right? That's the best way to go. Kohnerah.com, right here. This website we're showing you right now. That's where you go. Get a copy of the fucking record. Pick up a t-shirt. Do what you can to support these guys, man. And we're going to tell you why you should right now with a song. So tell me a little bit about this video we're going to play, man. I'm digging this shit, brother. But
so again, this guy fucking coming through.
Hey, there's several things I love about the band. I love the fucking brutality of it. I love the fucking the riffs and the death fucking language that you've provided me on the record. And yeah. I love that it reeks of hardworking dudes behind it, man. That shit speaks to me, man. I can tell a lot of hard work went behind this project.
Respect. Mad respect.
That video, like, was an idea, like, I don't know, Steven Babcock, our vocalist, he was like, kicking around the idea of wanting to do a comic book and, like, you know,
like an actual comic.
Yeah, like book. He and I were just kind of
kicking. I'm a comic book nerd. I love it.
Let the nerds take over.
Yeah, like, I was like, I don't know how to do this logistically, but why don't we just make a comic video instead? And I know it's been done before. It's not like it's like, you know, anything that's reinventing the wheel or anything.
It's fun. That's right. I love it. Yeah.
I just decided, you know, I would take his lyrics and basically do a sort of lighthearted take on the mysterious happenings of the, you know, cattle mutilations and whatnot. So there you have it.
This ought to be good.
I fucking love it. I am entertained by it. I'm a fan of you motherfucking guys, man. For real, dude. I'm loving what you're doing. Count the crypt firmly in your corner, man. If there's anything Metal-O-Mania can do to always hit us up.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
And I got to ask you, as this thing progresses, man, I'm going to reach out to you. Will you come back on and hang out with us again in the future, gentlemen?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Anytime.
Absolutely. Anytime.
Well, fuck yeah. On that note, man, what do you say, gentlemen? Should we punch everybody in the face and hit them with some, a little bit of fucking jammage here?
Yep. Do it.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Dude, you guys rock, man. I appreciate you hanging out with me. It means the world.
Yeah, no problem. For real.
Thank you for having us.
And now, metal.
Those guys are badass.
Hey, this is JD with Kohnerah.
And I'm Spencer.
And you're watching Metal-O-Mania with the Crypt and Scully.
Turn it up.
We'll be right back.
I would be a bovine, clod-pated, city-fied moron if I didn't hire you on the spot.
How stiff is my vile sense that I stand up and have ingenious feelings of my huge sorrows.
Appear! Appear! Our friendship and our magic were what Veronica and I depended on.
She will be missed.
Hey, make him like a snack, right?
Give me a snack.
Action Man Battlefield Casualties. For PTSD Action Man, danger lurks at every turn.
Sister!
He never feels safe, not even in his own home. Do what you can to block out the memories.
Look, look, look!
With no support from HQ, it's up to you to find a way.
Looks like we're on our own.
PTSD Action Man now comes with 1,000 Guard Stare Action. With time running out, only you can stop the pain.
Let's get out of here.
All right, this is Jason from Angerot, and you're listening to Metal-O-Mania with Crypt and Scully.
We'll be right back.
What a profound and reverent night is this.
African death mask. Died in some tribal ritual, I should think.
This axe, which has been fashioned from stone, has been used to circumcise tribal members for thousands and thousands of years.
That's all, bitches.
Yo, this is Heavy Kevy from Insanity Alert, and you're listening to Metal-O-Mania.
Hey, this is Michael Gilbert from Flotsam and Jetsam, and you're listening to Metal-O-Mania with the Krypton Scully.
This just in, scientists have discovered that once you've been infected by Metal-O-Mania, there is no cure. Contact Scully right away for more and more metal to feed the dragon.